Hi guys, and welcome to another Bootstrap video. This is Jamie from System 22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Well, in our last video we demonstrated how to upload your logo to the nav bar up here and make it boxed if you want to. Really easy to do with Bootstrap 5. Today what we're going to do is show you how to add a favicon. Now, a favicon is the little image that appears up in the browser tab right here. And again, this is really easy to do with Bootstrap 5, so let's get started. Okay, I'm going to be using the brackets text editor here. Brackets is absolutely free. If you don't have a text editor, you can download it from the link below the video. And this is where we left off last time. This is our index.html document. Here's our root folder where our website files are. We're looking at the index.html right here. That's what we're looking at in the brackets. We added our logo last time, and there's a custom style sheet here. We're not actually going to be using that at the moment. In fact, we don't need to apply any CSS to this today at all. So the first thing we want to do is let's just open this up. So I can double click on the index.html and it'll open in your browser of choice here. As you can see, there's a default favicon there. There's no favicon. So to add one, let's go back to our folder here. I'm going to drag an image in, and it's best to use a transparent image such as a PNG. You can use a JPEG if you want to, but PNG tends to work better because sometimes tabs have different colors like this one up here, and it'll just work better, especially if you're using a round one. So I'm going to drag a little image across here. There it is. I've called mine Fav. You don't need to call it that. You can call it what you want, but that just lets me know what it is. I'm actually using an image of 400 by 400, which is probably a bit too big for this, but it'll work fine. The image that shows up here is usually 16 by 16, and on iPads and things like that, it can get bigger. So I'm using a bigger one just in case. So now we need to tell our little HTML document where this is and where to put it. So let's go back into the brackets. And up at the top, in the head section up here, you see this says head. There's the end of the head right there, and there's where our body starts. I'm going to put mine just under the title. And for anybody who wants to know, the title's right there. You can put in what you want. Put a pipe in and put a description if you want. If I save that now, Control S and refresh this, you see it's changed it up there for us. Just thought I'd drop that in there. Okay, well, let's put our little favicon in. So it's in our root folder, so it should be very easy to find for us. I'm just going to drop down below the title here. I'm going to open and close some pointy brackets. And inside, I'm going to put link and rel equals, and we've got to tell it what it is. So I'll open and open some inverted commas here, and it's an icon, and it's prompted us there, or you can just type it in. Okay, so where is it? So next we have to say href, the link to it, equals, open and close some more, and it's actually found it in there. It's looking straight into our root folder there where we put our file. If I go back to that folder, it's in our root folder, so we just have to put the name of it to find it. A lot of times, as we discussed last time, you put this in an image folder. You just, whatever you called your image folder where you want to store all your images, you just put the name and then a forward slash and then the name of it, and it'll find it. Great, so there it is, favping, or you can just type it in here. As I said, it's a portable network graphic file. Okay, and after that, if you want to, you can specify sizes by putting in sizes. And again, equals. Open and close some more inverted commas right there. And the regular one, like I say, is 16 by 16. So put in 16 by 16. No gaps in between any of this. And if you want to add another one for larger displays, put in 32 by 32, etc. That's great. Now we need to just tell it what type it is, what it is exactly. And so it's an image and it's a ping. So type equals, again, in open some inverted commas, and it's an image. And specifically, it's a PNG file. And that's all there is to it. Now when we say this, it should find our favicon, if I spell it correctly, which I haven't done there. It's a dot. There we go. And the thing about brackets is great. If you hover over there, it'll give you an actual example of your image so you know you're pointing to the right thing. So there we go. And as long as everything's correctly done here, we should save, and our little favicon should appear up there. So let's save. Control S to save. And with brackets, if you're using brackets, if I just put something in here, just do a little change, you'll notice there's a little dot appears up here. That indicates that you've got something that's not saved. Once you save it, Control S, or File and Save, it goes away like that. So we're all saved. Let's refresh our site, and we should have a little favicon right there. And there it is. Simple as that. And for branding, it's a great idea to have a little favicon up there, because if you've got a generic sort of bootstrap logo, or if you're working with WordPress or something, you have the generic WordPress, it just doesn't look quite as good. And what I was saying before, if your images are all floating around in your root folder, quite often when you build a site you're going to have a lot of images, so it's a good idea to put your images into a little folder. If I create a new folder here, I'll call it images. Whatever you want to call yours is fine. We'll move our fav into there, and we can move our logo in there as well if you want to, but we'll have to change the path for both of those. And we'll go back into our document here. Now if I refresh this page, that's going to be missing and this is going to be missing. There we go, we just got the blank alt text there and back to the generic there. We just need to update the path. And it's what I was saying earlier. Our folder is called images. If I just delete all of this. Images. Forward slash. It'll find it as soon as I put the forward slash in there. There it is. There's our favicon. And also down here where we put that logo in. Right here. Source logo. If I get rid of that. Again. The name of the folder where we've put it, and the actual name of the file, which is logo right there. Control S to save and refresh. We should be back. There we go. And like I say, it is good practice to put your images in a separate folder, because it can get too congested in here with sort of images floating around. But that's entirely up to you. It'll still work. So there you go, guys. There's how to add a favicon to your Bootstrap 5 website. Really easy to do. So I hope you've enjoyed this today and found it useful. If you have, please give it a thumbs up, comment, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Once again, this has been Jamie with System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.